if you bring awareness to it, kids are going to want to take action towards stopping it.
I'm the Teen Education and Outreach Coordinator for North Idaho Violence Prevention Center.
I primarily go out into the middle schools, the high schools, and over to our local college, and I talk about healthy relationships. I talk about dating violence, sexual harassment, bullying, sexual assault and rape, stalking, anything that a teen may encounter in an abusive relationship.
I'm a high school student at Coeur d'Alene High School. You don't have to feel like you are the only one, because you aren't. You know, there's so many people going through it, and there's so much help that you can get. And being able to open up about it now, rather than, you know, how you had to keep your mouth shut in the past, is something that has changed dramatically.
If people realize that it would be a lot more cost effective to fund programs like ours instead of doing the cleanup, which is what law enforcement, the judicial system, medical, mental health, chemical dependency, substance abuse, social service agencies all have to do when they're cleaning up from the mess of family violence and sexual assault.
We provide shelter for 30 days for anybody escaping domestic violence and sexual assault for them and their children.
That care includes being able to make them feel safe and that they are no longer threatened, and anything that they have done or they have witnessed is not their fault. And we want to bring them in and make them feel that they have someone that they can talk to.
How do you feel after you come to see me?
I feel happy and safe.
It's not something that you can just overlook. Even at this young age that these kids are learning this, that, you know, they'll pass it on to their children and they'll be able to work against it because of the education that they have.
We're now in our fifth year, and it looks like we're going to surpass last year's numbers. Last year we talked to over 2,800 students and spent over 260 hours in the school. So every year we've talked to more students and spent more time in the schools. And I do think it's making a difference. One thing that's been really gratifying for me, I get a lot more openness, and a lot more students are receptive to what I'm saying.
Everybody thinks it won't happen to me, but it could happen to anyone. I know what it's like to feel alone. I know what it's like, because I went through that I want to make it where they don't have to feel that. They can have somebody that's next to them. They can know that they aren't alone through this.